Hi everybody, this is Kevin, and welcome back to another video. And today, I would like to share with you all the video games that I picked up over the past few months. You know, I was looking back at my channel, and the last haul video I uploaded was all the way back in July, so it's been a number of months. I have quite a few games to share with you, including four limited editions. They're all either on the PS4 or PS5, and most of these games I bought back in August and September through various summer sales, and I'll tell you how much I paid for them. Some of them are quite a steal, but others, you know, pay full price. Of course, East 10 Nordics, which you're looking at right here, the limited edition, and I will be doing an unboxing of this, which I'll upload next week. But with the other limited editions I'm going to show you here, I need you to comment down below if you want me to unbox them on the channel as well, because, you know, in East 10 Nordics' case, this is Nice America. They do a great job with the limited editions. There's an art book, CD, sometimes an acrylic figure. In this case, they actually sent me this bag. Like, what the hell even is this? The sling bag, not sling blade, sling bag. So we got that. I don't know what the hell I'm gonna use that for, but they sent it for me. I'll show that in the video next week. And with the other limited editions, as I was trying to say, one of them is from a more niche game that just released a few weeks ago, so I don't know what the interest level is there, but the other two, one's from last year, and then another one's from like 5 years ago. So again, once I show you, you'll get an idea, and then just leave a comment if you want me to unbox them as well, because I think there's cool stuff in there too, with art books and the whole nine yards. But anyway, let's begin. East 10 Nordics. I'm currently playing through East 8 Lacrimosa of Donna right now. What an excellent game. Look forward to my review of that relatively soon, I hope. I have a backlog of reviews right now. I got Fate Stay Night, Astrobot, Soul Hackers 2, you name it. But looking forward to playing this eventually. After East 8, of course, I have to play East 9 Monstrum Nox and then East 10 Nordics. I was debating whether or not to dive into East 9 right away, but I think I'll take a little bit of a break and then play something else, then go back to East 9. But looking forward to this. We have the beautiful Karja, who is voiced by my favorite female voice actor, Shirami Lei. Can't wait to hear her in the game. And then the legend, Adol Kristen, which, what's all his hairdo there? He usually keeps it nice and combed, and here it is blown in the wind. But as I say that, I think I answered my own question, because isn't he a pirate in this game or something? He has a ship. It's like, again, East, the better version of Zelda. It's East Wind Waker, but better. So there they are on the back. Looking forward to checking that out. Check back next week to see all the goodies inside here. Next up, a game that released like 2 weeks ago, I think. We have Farmagia, the Day One Edition, which this is the Hiro Mashima game. I don't know if he was involved in the story, but he designed all the characters. And I've been interested in this ever since I saw the trailer at the Nintendo Direct. Just because of Hiro Mashima, I love the designs of his characters. And despite the game, I don't know how good it's going to be. Like, honestly, it looks kind of mid, just to be honest. But, you know, it's Hiro Mashima. I'll give it the benefit of the doubt. And typically, if you go into games with low expectations, you enjoy them a lot more. So, again, the beautiful character art, which that's the Lucy ripoff, as they say. Although, I think that chick's hotter with the blonde hair. Oh, I love the blondies. But Raise Your Monster Buddies from Seeds, a fast-paced monster action game brought to life by Hiro Mashima. Battle throughout the underworld where people and monsters coexist. Tend your farm to harvest new monster buddies, train monsters, and amass your army. Command your monsters on the field of battle. And the reason why I bought this at launch, because this will probably go on sale relatively soon, but we have the game for PS5, original soundtrack with 23 tracks, and then the 96-page full-color art book. And you can kind of see a little bit right there. It's the Mashima artwork, so you love to see it. Just leave a comment if you want me to unbox this from Marvelous. And is it from Exceed Games as well? I thought Exceed Games was involved with it as well, but I guess just Marvelous. So there's that. Next up, these games sort of go hand in hand, so I'll show them together. There's actually three, technically. I'll explain in a moment, but here we go. We have Granblue Fantasy Relink and Granblue Fantasy Versus, as well as Granblue Fantasy Versus Rising. So the order of release was actually this game, then Granblue Fantasy Versus Rising, which is digital only, and then Granblue Fantasy Relink. And this game has been in my crosshairs for a number of years because the combat reminded me of the Trails games, but as I learned more about it and saw more trailers, saw the characters, it's for the waifus. In particular, you can hardly see her. I'll make her the thumbnail, that's what I'll do. But this one right here, the pink hair, Narmaya. Oh my God, she's so sexy. So yes, I bought the game, number one, because of the combat, but number two, because of the waifus. And oh, yeah, that's why. So I paid $40 for this. Limited edition that released last year. I think this originally retailed for $100, $40. And then this one, $30, limited edition as well. So what's even in it? It's the premium edition, full game, limited edition box of original art, special soundtrack CD, special art book, PS4 theme. There's no themes on the PS5. And then PSN avatar set and then DLC. So I explained this. The reason for the fighting games, this one and then Versus Rising, is because it's Arc System Works, the same people who did the Blaze Blue games. And I love Blaze Blue Cross Tag Battle and can't wait to play the other Blaze Blue games, which I showed them all in the last haul video. I got all four of them. So we have RPG mode, power up your characters while enjoying a compelling story, and that's Blaze Blue. It's like a visual novel story, it's Kino as fuck, and then awesome 2D action fighting. And then Versus mode, fight with an intuitive yet extensive battle system. So there you go. I wonder if these codes even work anymore, but you know, so looking forward to that. And then with Grand Blue, this one looks even thicker, but this is PS4 only. This one was PS4 and PS5. And this is the deluxe edition. We have the game, special artwork, special art book, 116 pages. Let me know if you want to unbox this because I'm sure we'll get some good stuff with Narmaya and the other waifus. Special soundtrack CD with 12 music tracks, postcard pack, 5 cards, Grand Blue special item set, day one DLC voucher, in-game item set voucher code, step forth beyond the blue, welcome to the forgotten sky, what's that say, Zega Grande Skydom, here, whispers of the secret church of Avius begin to spread, and behind those whispers a web of intrigue starts to unfurl. Brave skyfarers, you must fight for the fate of the sky realm. So the evil church. Journey alongside a varied cast of Grand Blue Fantasy characters. Experience thrilling action RPG combat with a party of four. Take down mighty foes in four-player online co-op play. So there you go. And then, like I explained, Versus Rising is the sequel to this. I think because it's like Arc System Works, Blaze Blue, more story, more characters. I saw the DLC. 2B is a DLC character. But yeah, you can kind of see the characters here. They're all great. Look at that hottie. Oh my goodness. I can't wait. All right, I guess the next thing I'll show you guys is this right here, which buying the same game multiple times, like the genius I am, but I got the physical edition of Final Fantasy Pixel Remaster Collection, the 6 games, which I bought all these digitally on the PS4. I bought them all in the past on the Game Boy Advance, at least the Game Boy Advance versions they had, and then 3 was on the DS, not the 3DS, just the regular DS. But, I mean, Square Enix just goofed with the initial release of this because, number one, they released them on Steam. Then, like, a couple years went by, then they finally released them on consoles. They had a limited print of the physical editions, sold out really quick. I caved and bought the digital editions, and then years later again, they released more physical editions, and for $75, and I still bought it. Like, what does that say about me? So I spent $75 twice, three times even, for the other versions I bought on the Game Boy Advance and DS, like I already explained. But my goodness, it comes with a sticker sheet. I'm not even taking it out of the plastic. I have this for my collection. The games that inspired a generation come to life once more in the ultimate 2D pixel remaster. Updated 2D pixel graphics, beautifully rearranged soundtrack, bestiary, galleries, and music player, improved gameplay, UI, and more. These are definitely the definitive versions to play, although I still have my gripes, and I feel like what they did with the PSP version of Final Fantasy IV, they should have done that with all of them, which they did that with 1 and 2. So for those of you who haven't watched my reviews, well, obviously check the playlist, the video game reviews playlist, and I think I have a Final Fantasy reviews playlist as well. My favorite Final Fantasy game of the Pixel Remasters is 5. It's not 6, it's not 4, it's 5. I love Final Fantasy 5. And then I really like 2. I don't know if I can say 2 is my second favorite. 6 is probably my second favorite, but 2 is up there. 2 is the best of the NES games. And that is an ultimate litmus test for Final Fantasy fans, their opinion of Final Fantasy 2. If they're one of those, oh, the leveling mechanic. No, shut the fuck up and go back to wherever you came from. If you can't respect Final Fantasy 2, you gotta go. You gotta go back. So, Final Fantasy Pixel Collection. All right, what should I show you next? I guess I'll keep the Square Enix trend going. These games I picked up from one of the sales during, you know, it was either August or September, somewhere around there. Square Enix had a big sale. I'm going to show you 4 games now, ranging from $10 to $30. So let's start with, oh my god, I'm dropping everything. Let's start with the most expensive from this stack, and that's Octopath Traveler 2, which I spent $30 on. And I'm not sure if this originally retailed for $60 or $70, because I know PS5 games are $70, but that might just be first-party games, because Octopath Traveler 2 is also on the PS4, PC, Switch, Xbox, it's on every console. And now Octopath Traveler 1 is on every console, but I think just digitally only, because I saw there was like a bundle to get Octopath Traveler 1 and 2 digitally for like $80. And despite having Octopath Traveler 1 on the Switch, I do want it now on the PS5, so I can play both games on the same console and get the trophies, because I'm a weirdo like that. But yeah, Octopath Traveler 1, I never beat it. I've spent like maybe 30, 40 hours on it. Great game. This game I played the demo 2 years ago, and seems to be better than the first Octopath Traveler game, the HD 2D Kino turn-based. So you already know how I feel about that. Embark on an adventure all your own. And here's the characters. So, lots of good stuff. In the world of Celestia, 8 new travelers venture forth into an exciting new era. Where will you go? What will you do? Whose tale will you bring to life? Every path is yours to take. I don't even know what kind of accent I'm doing, but anyway. Explore a wide world set in a bustling era. Choose between 8 new travelers with intertwining stories. Outsmart your foes with the turn-based break and boost combat system. So yeah, it's the same thing. Looks like a great cast of characters here. So definitely looking forward to playing that at some point. Next, we'll go to the next most expensive game. This was $20. Tactics Ogre Reborn. I don't know when I'm gonna ever play this game. I just bought it because it was $20. So I said, you know what, it's $20. Add it to the backlog. But I think this is a remaster from the PSP game, which is in turn a remaster of, it was either on the PlayStation or something or other. But Tactics Ogre Reborn. The crown jewel of the tactical role-playing genre is reborn! Tactics Ogre Reborn features updated game design, fully voiced cutscenes, improved graphics and sound. Immerse yourself in the fascinating world and intrigue of Tactics Ogre like never before. In this age of conflict, which path will you choose? So there's multiple story paths and endings, redesigned HD visuals, updated AI, numerous improvements. And, you know, $20. Add it to the backlog. Who knows when I'll play it, but I got it now. And then these games, I spent $10 each on them. We'll start with the Diophil Chronicle, which I played the demo of this like 2 years ago as well. Reminds me a lot of the Growlancer games, and I've heard nothing but good things about it. Definitely looking forward to playing this. You know, Tactics Ogre Reborn is kind of an impulse buy. This, I do want to play, so. The era of myths gives way to a new era of great turmoil. When the world of men is mired in an age of war which rages for years on end, a band of elite mercenaries, calling themselves the Blue Foxes, arise amidst the flames and the chaos. Their fates and valiant deeds to be sung of in the ages yet to come. But when all is said and done, will the name the Blue Foxes come to signify hope or darkest tragedy? So we have deep strategic real-time tactical battles, realistic diorama style battle scenes, and a new strategy RPG that chronicles an epic tale of war and honor. I like how they spelled honor like the old English with the U. In America, there would be no U there, but that's cool. So yeah, I do want to play the Diophil Chronicle. And another game I got for $10 is Valkyrie Elysium, which everyone shit on this game. Again, I put all these games, they all sort of go hand in hand. They all released back in 2022, the same time as Star Ocean The Divine Force, which I had my eyes on all these games around that time, but I settled for Star Ocean The Divine Force, which ended up being my favorite game that released in 2022. But I played pretty much all the demos except for Tactics Ogre Reborn, and I really did like them, but it's almost like, stop releasing so many games because I can't catch up. But you know, when I see it for $10, I'm gonna buy it. But yeah, Valkyrie Elysium, Action Combat. I also bought it, you know, I mentioned before Grand Blue Fantasy, Narmaya being sexy as hell. This chick is hot as hell too. Here's some more, look at her. Oh, love her. So, I don't think it's Valkyrie Leta from the original Valkyrie profile, but you know, she's cute nonetheless. Here begins the tale of a new Valkyrie. Long ago, Ragnarok, the end times loomed over the realms. The Allfather, Odin, with the last of his strength, created an emissary of redemption. Her sole task, the salvation of a doomed world. Summon Arnheriar and unleash devastating combos. Find your humanity and discover the truth behind Ragnarok. Explore a beautiful fantasy world on the brink of ruin. Which, yeah. So looking forward to that for the cute girl. I think this has a reversible cover, which we can see her in better detail. Well, maybe not, but because I'm not going to bother taking it out. But you get the idea. So yeah, Kevin, he buys his games for the gameplay and the waifus. Let's continue. I have a few more things. It's going to be a long video. That's why I can't do the unboxings in the video, because I have so much shit to show you. All right, let's show you this game. This is a relatively new game, which I already beat. We have Astrobot, which Astrobot is the better version of Super Mario Galaxy. And I already beat this game. It's kind of sad because it's gone and forgotten already. Like, people loved it for the week it released. But after that, you know, it's kind of, what are they talking about now? But yeah, I already beat this game and actually have my review recorded because I like to have a backlog of videos just because it becomes a hassle to record a video before, you know, it's supposed to be scheduled. And I like to have, you know, two or three videos in the backlog. So in case I don't want to record, I can just upload whatever. So, you know, that's sort of the behind the scenes, how to make it work as a YouTuber, I guess. But Astrobot, in my review, I'm definitely more positive. I love the game. Each level was varied and it was a lot of fun. And just seeing all the cameos, all the characters we haven't seen in quite some time, like seeing a character like Soul Bad Guy, I mean, from Guilty Gear, how cool is that? And with this, you know, PS5 game I mentioned before, most PS5 games retail for $70. This game was only $60. Of course, you get the disc, and like nobody gives you these things anymore. Which, yeah, there's bonus stuff. I already redeemed that. You get the Parappa, the Rappa costume, the different color for the dual sense, and then the avatars. But there's like it's like a comic, and then I think a poster. So like, what games give you a poster anymore? No one even gives you a manual. But it's kind of like, this is the beginning of the game where Astro crash lands or whatever. Oh, it's even bigger. There's another sheet. Like, it's just a cute little thing. And then, that's what Astro's Playroom showed you, is the game took place inside the PS5, so, you know, I'll just leave this up the rest of the video, why not? But the cool thing with Astrobot is the fact that they are doing DLC. They've already released some. I think, wasn't Eve from, what's that game? Stellar Blade. That's one of the DLC. I think Helldivers, some other characters have cameos in the DLC, and it's free DLC. So I think every week or every other week, they're going to release something new. They did that with Astro's Playroom in the lead up to Astrobot, where, you know, they announced this and there was a couple months, and each month they had a new bot to rescue, and then you could carry the bots over into Astrobot. And if you do everything, this is like a 25-hour game. People are saying, oh, you beat it in 10 hours. I mean, if you rush through the levels, you'll beat it in 10 hours, but if you explore every nook and cranny and rescue all the bots, it's going to take you 25 hours plus all the DLC, which I haven't touched it yet. I'm gonna go, once all the DLC is released, I'll go back to Astro's Bot and play it all, and maybe do another video reviewing the DLC. But yeah, I strongly recommend it. If you're a PlayStation fan who enjoys Mario games, you like Super Mario Galaxy, I shit you not, the better version of Super Mario Galaxy, and it's not a joke, you know, as Joe Biden would say. Anyway, some more stuff. Dude, how about this? From Limited Run Games, Grandia, the HD collection. Which, these are classic. I think they're on the PlayStation 1, maybe the PlayStation 2 as well. But let's see, we celebrate these exciting adventures once again. Grandia 1 and Grandia 2. Grandia tells the story of Justin, the protagonist, and his companions in the race against the evil Garlisle forces to uncover the long-lost secrets of an ancient civilization. And then Grandia 2 take on the role of a hardened mercenary with a heart and go on an epic adventure filled with magic, new friendships, and surprising storyline twists in search of a weapon once wielded by a deity. Experience the classic tale of a band of adventurers destined to save the world, but things are not always as they seem. And it's from Square Enix and Gung Ho Games. Enhanced details to the UI, sprites, and texture art, original cinematic videos receiving visual enhancements, widescreen support, Japanese and English audio. I think there's voice acting in this, if you can believe that. And then normal or hard mode. All right, I gotta get rid of this Astrobot mat because it's kind of getting in my way. I know I said I would leave it out, but let's see the other things inside here. Looks like there's a reversible cover, the HD collection, and some trading cards of some sort, as well as a manual. And I know people will talk about limited run games and say, oh, it's fucking woke, the SJWs. Which, look, I'm against woke and SJWs and DEI and all that other bullshit. But if there's good games on there that I want to get physically, I'm going to use limited run games. I bought Persona 3 Portable and Persona 4 Golden through them. And those games were only like $30. I think this is only like $40. So it's not even like full price, $60, $70 game. So good stuff right there. Almost done, guys. I got three more games to show you. Okay, yeah. Next up is the Atlas Summer Sale. Three Atlas games on the PS5. We got Like a Dragon, Infinite Wealth, which I guess is not called Yakuza anymore. It's Like a Dragon, not Yakuza Like a Dragon, Infinite Wealth, which I've only played Yakuza Like a Dragon. I guess that's Yakuza 7. I'm going to go back and play the other games first. I'm going to play Zero. Or, you know, Nuke told me I should play them in order, in release order. So play like 1 to 5 or whatever it is, then go back and play 0, then play 6, whatever the release order is. I agree with release order. I honestly think that's the way to go about things too, because talk about Fate's Day Night. No, don't watch Fate 0 first. Watch 06 Fate's Day Night or read the visual novel first. What are you talking about? So with this game, I think you get two different perspectives from the story, where you get to control Ichiban for part of it, and then you switch over to Kiryu. And then I guess eventually their paths converge, kind of like Trails to Reverie in a certain sense. But I also think there's another game I'm missing out. There's The Man Who Erased His Name, which takes place in between Yakuza Like a Dragon, Yakuza 7, and then this one, Like a Dragon Infinite Wealth. And then there's also the Judgment games. I think there's two of them, Judgment and Lost Judgment, and the characters from them might have appearances in this game as well. But let's take a look. We have The Fates of Two Dragons. Two larger-than-life heroes are brought together by the hand of fate, or perhaps something more sinister. Ichiban Kasuga, an unstoppable underdog who's no stranger to crawling up from rock bottom. And Kazuma Kiryu, a broken man facing down his last days, explore Japan and Hawaii in an RPG adventure so big it spans the Pacific. And dude, isn't this character, I think that's Danny Trejo. He voices the character. That character looks just like him. I think that's the case. I remember seeing that. But, you know, looking forward to playing this one in a couple of years, I suppose, because I have the other Yakuza games to play. It looks like we got a Dachi there, Nanba, all the rest of them. I always love the Dachi. If you stand idle controlling him in the overworld for a minute or so, he'll start stretching and he'll say something like, "Oh, my back is killing me." And it's just literally me at this point. But wow, this one actually has some goodies in here. A sticker, looks like another poster. That's cool, it's just the cover, I think. But it's cool, I like when companies go the extra, oh, look at that one. I like when they go the extra mile just to include the bare minimum, please. And look at that. Psycho, what is going on there? She's a tennis star, is that Ichiban as a football player? That's cool. God, she looks pretty cute in that tennis outfit. My goodness. But anyway, I'll play one of these days. I don't know, man. $30, sometimes you just can't pass up getting these deals. But another game I spent $30 on, game that's going right into the backlog. I don't know when the hell I'll play this game, but I got it for $30. It's Persona 3 Reload. And, you know, The more I've seen about this game, the only thing I don't really care for is the fact that they changed the voice actors, because the original cast on the PS2 is iconic. I mean, you have Michelle Ruff, you have Liam O'Brien, Vic Mignogna, Tara Platt, you have, Karen Strassman as Igus. I mean, such an iconic cast of voice actors, and they recast them all in this game, mainly, I think, because of Vic Mignogna. But so many of them, like Liam O'Brien and Tara Platt, they reprised their roles relatively recently in BlazBlue Crosstag Battle, so I don't know, man, but, you know, it's $30, I had to pick it up. Enter the dark hour and seal your fates. Step into the shoes of a transfer student, thrust into an unexpected fate when entering the hour, hidden between one day and the next. Awaken an incredible power and chase the mysteries of the dark hour. Fight for your friends and leave a mark on their memories forever. And I know there's like DLC with this too. You get Persona 4 Golden. Reach out to the truth. I face out. I pull out. I reach out to the truth. Do, 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 do.
I face out. I pull out.
Oh my god. Oh, I'm just... what the fuck even is this video, guys? I have no idea. I have one more game to show you. Just sit tight. So the last game, and this is the main reason why I bought the other Atlas games anyway, because I was mainly looking for this one game, but what happened was I saw the others on sale. I'm like, oh, I can't resist the Atlas sale. And that's Persona 5 Tactica, which I only paid $20 for this one. And the reason why I bought it is because I just recently finished playing Persona 5 Strikers. Check out my review of that. I actually prefer Persona 5 Strikers to Persona 5 Royal. The only thing where Persona 5 Royal is better, in my opinion, is the turn-based combat. But I like the story more in Persona 5 Strikers, especially Sophia, Zenkichi, and Ichinose, the three new characters. They were fucking awesome. So yeah, I wanted to spend more time with the Persona 5 cast. And I don't give a fuck if Persona 5 is overrated. In fact, give me the Arc Systems Persona 5 Arena right now. But for now, we can play Persona 5 Tactica, which I love the little chibi artwork. I know people are like, oh, it's chibi, I can't do that. No, it's cute. I like them all. So we got Persona 5 Tactica. Let's see. Ignite a fire in your hearts. Join the Phantom Thieves as they lead an uprising of the hearts in a thrilling combat adventure set in Persona's iconic universe. Lead an emotional revolution. Communist revolution now? build your dream squad and dynamic tactical combat. And it's rated T, whereas Persona 5, Royal, and Strikers were all rated M. So, oh no, we can't sexualize the chibis. Does An have her cleavage? That's all I need to know. I need the chibi cleavage. But, oh, we got some DLC. Okay, well, this video has gone completely off the rails. Like I said, a ton of shit to show you. I'm not going to recap because you can just go back and see what you missed. Again, leave a comment if you want me to unbox the Pharmagia or the Grand Blue Fantasy Relink and Versus Deluxe Editions or Limited Editions, whatever they called them. But definitely next week I will be unboxing the East 10 Nordics Limited Edition, so stay tuned for that. Otherwise, that's about all. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment down below what you thought of this, what you picked up recently, and stay tuned for more videos coming very, very soon. Everyone have a great day, and peace out. 99.